and laying his finger aside of his nose, then giving a nod up the chimney he rose. But I heard him exclaim as he drove out of sight, "Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night."
Sound asleep.
Thank God. I thought he'd never shut up.
Now Santa can come.
Good one, babe.
Thanks.
Let's get to work.
Steve.
Yeah, Joy?
Remember when you were a kid and you would get so excited to wake up in the morning because Santa came and there were presents under the tree?
Yeah. You turn 8 and realize Santa Claus is a phony.
I mean, I guess.
But, I mean, there's other things to be excited about, like, how it's baby's first Christmas.
Of course I'm excited about that. It's a different kind of excitement.
Yeah. Then he grows up, of course, and starts going to school, and some loser in his third grade class tells him, "Your parents are Santa Claus, and Santa's not real, you dummy." Then he comes home and starts crying and blames us for getting bullied at school. He calls us liars and slams his bedroom door shut and cries for 3.5 hours. He comes out feeling okay, and then the years go on, of course, and he probably has trust issues for the rest of his life, but I mean, who doesn't, right? Trick or treat!
That's funny, Gabriel.
Ah, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, can I help you?
I just came to wish you enjoy a Merry Christmas. And I have some figgy pudding back at home. If you guys want to come over, get figgy with it.
I'm okay. We're actually wrapping some gifts right now, and we're gonna be up really late getting ready for a baby's first Christmas, so I don't see that happening.
Right.
All right, Gabriel, well, you have a good night.
Who's that, babe?
That's just Gabriel. He wanted to know if he wanted some figgy pudding. Neighbors.
It's me again. I lied about the figgy... Well, I didn't lie about the figgy pudding. There is some at my house. But that's not why I came over here.
Why did you come over here?
I felt, as your neighbor, and yours, hi Joy, I felt that it was a part of my neighborly duties to impart some information onto your souls. I am the angel, Gabriel. You may have heard of me. I've been in like a lot of the Christmas story. Well, I've been in the Christmas story, really.
But Gabriel, we really don't have time for this. I mean, we gotta get ready for Christmas. It's a big day tomorrow. I'm sure you understand.
I totally get it, but that's exactly why I feel like we should talk about some things that could make some time.
It's midnight, babe. He's being rude.
How did you... Angel. Duh. Thank you for the cocoa, Joy.
Oh, of course. It's my aunt's famous recipe.
Janice. How is she?
Oh, she's great. I'll tell her you say hi.
Great.
Gabriel, what are you doing here? Is Joy pregnant with the Son of God or something?
No, Steve. Let's say 2,000 years ago. No, I'm here to share a secret with you. As you guys know, you guys are new parents, which means you are entitled to an annual visit from the big man himself.
Jesus?
No. Santa.
What?
Yeah, no. When new parents have their child, Santa will bring that child gifts, and then if they decide to have some more, he'll bring those children gifts as well. It's Santa, that's what he does.
You're kidding.
No. How'd you think you got your gifts?
My parents bought them?
Steve, you were poor. Your parents could barely afford to keep you alive. Steve, your dad was a milkman. In 98. They couldn't get you the Nintendo 64 when you were 6. Steve, they could barely feed you. You were really poor, man.
Okay, I was poor. Big whoop.
Okay, well, what about me? My parents were pretty rich.
You were on the naughty list for most of your life. Your parents bought you your gifts. You were one of the lucky ones. If they hadn't bought them for you, you would have gotten coal every year.
Shut up.
Anyway, Santa will be here soon. I just came to tell you guys that. Leave out the milk and cookies, extinguish the fireplace, yada, yada, yada. Oh, Christmas tree, oh, Christmas tree. Ho, ho, ho. I gotta go.
What just happened? Where are you going?
Santa's coming. Come on!
See.
No, we'll get in trouble.
No, we won't. Come on.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir. And folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows. Christmas. Hi, Joy.
Hi, Santa.
Still naughty. Yeah. Listen, it was very nice meeting you both. And congratulations on baby's first Christmas. Keep them on the nice list. Steve, you come from good genes, so I know you can do this. Well, I better get going. I got a lot more homes to cover before I get back to the North Pole. And you know, Mrs. Claus, she be tripping.
Bitches ain't shit.
But hoes and tricks.
Man, he was thirsty.
He was so cool.
Am I dreaming?
It's a Christmas miracle.
Thank you.